Introducing Thermo Calc 2025B, packed with exciting new features. This release offers 8 new databases with extensive additions. A new version of our nickel-based superalloys database, TCNI13, adds elastic constants, as well as many other improvements. A new version of our high entropy alloys database, TC-HEA8, adds oxygen, a much requested addition, as well as elastic constants and more. Our aluminum-based alloys database, TCAL10, has been upgraded to support applications for aluminum recycling, a better understanding of grain refiners in processing, and more. Our magnesium-based alloys database, TCMG8, has been enhanced to perform rare earth calculations for several magnesium, rare earth, tin systems. 4 additional new databases are available with this release, as well as 1 updated database. Several usability improvements are included in ThermoCalc 2025B. Plot and table variables have been grouped into intuitive categories, offering faster navigation through the expansive list of quantities. And a new Show More button streamlines the plot renderer window by hiding non-essential fields. Database properties are shown in the system definer for easy access to this valuable information. Users can now reverse axes in ternary diagrams, a much requested feature for comparing thermocalc plots to those found in scientific literature. And a new swap button simplifies this process in all 2D plots. The Martensitic steel strength model has been extended to a full flow stress model, able to predict stress at arbitrary strain in the form of several properties. You can also predict engineering properties, such as yield strength, yield strain, and more. The Diffusion Module DICTRA adds automatic grid placement to the graphical mode, and new settings have been added for controlling grid accuracy in both graphical and console modes. Additionally, the program now displays the smallest and largest grid spacing points to prevent unusable grid point spacings. The Precipitation Module TC-PRISMA receives a significant speed improvement for non-isothermal simulations, with a demonstrated reduction of up to 80%. Meshing is also improved in the module for certain simulations, providing improved accuracy. And it is now possible to create user-defined expressions for interfacial energies of precipitate phases in TC Python with the Precipitation module. The Additive Manufacturing module receives several improvements in this release. 2 new beam shapes have been added to the heat source options, top hat and core ring, offering better control over energy distribution during the printing process. The ray tracing model has been improved to account for full ray tracing, including upward reflecting rays, which were ignored in the previous model for simplicity. And Rayleigh length has been replaced with M2 in this release to make the keyhole model more consistent with additive manufacturing machine settings. Join our webinar to explore all the new features, upgrades, and databases available in this release. Learn more today at thermocalc.com/2025B.